So, after watching Kappa Kaiju's newest video about Yandere Simulator, I remembered, oh, that game's still a thing? Like, what the fuck? So, in honor of our weeb king, I'm gonna make two videos on Yandere Simulator. The first video, which is this one, obviously, I'll be exploring other ways the Hitman X Persona 5 kind of way could function. And the second one will be exploring alternative development methods that don't just boil down to give up the game and give it to someone else, like actual ways in real life to fix Yandere Simulator without just saying stuff that everyone else has said. That video might be a bit shorter because everyone else has most probably said stuff that, you know, should be done because, bro, it's been 6 years since you uploaded the game. And if you don't know what Yandere Simulator is, it's basically you are in a school. You murder people so you can be with this boy. But here's the thing, the game has been in development for 6 years, and you can't even say, oh, look, he's one guy. Because guess what? Toby Fox, nearly all by himself, made one of the most revolutionary indie games in 3 years. Right? In 3 years. That's half. Oh, but it's 3D, you may be saying. It's got less content than Undertale, come on. It's stupid. So anyway, let's ignore how stupid it is, and let's just go to redesigning the concept of Yandere Simulator. So, you see, Hitman is a game where you hide, plan, kill, and escape. No talking, no fat, no character development. But RPGs like Persona 5 are all about characters, reading and having actual fun. Like, huh? So, how do we mix cold, unloving murder with cute, charming, and very lovable RPG? Well, Yandere Simulator actually kind of comes close, but not really. I enjoy the concept of a psycho wanting someone so bad they would kill. But instead of just a school, let's change the game loop of school kill pajama time to waking up, school, after school activities, hangout, and pajama time. This gives us a brand new range of gameplay options and ways of playing the game. But how do these gameplay aspects work? Well, when you wake up, you can choose one item to sneak in, using your skirt, into the school. This could be a knife, a pen, somewhere to cheat in exams, anything. That's up for Yandere Simulator to decide, really. You can choose your panties, as they call. I'm gonna keep some of the aspects of Yandere Simulator because he's a creepy guy, and fuck it, you know? I'm gonna keep in some of the stuff, which give you bonus steps. And some optional things that you can do, there are senpai collectibles. So, senpai will every day leave one certain object somewhere where you can pick him up, like an apple with teeth marks in it, or his toothbrush, or something like that. And you can use that to collect and create a giant shrine. It's basically just a collectible, nothing too special. And you can look at the daily news, so if you killed someone in the news, there'll be a death, and you can figure out if the police are on you or not. It'd be interesting. So, after setting up and having an idea of, okay, I want to bring this item into school because of this reason, unless you've really just started the game where you don't have any items, you go to school. Now, school is where you meet brand new characters, and this is where the RPG system will be in place. Basically, you will have a group of characters that will come up to you and talk to you. They can be anywhere from just a basic ragtag group. The innocent one, the emo one, the smart one, the smarter one, the stronger one, basically a basic anime party, and those are your new friends. You actually enjoy these characters, and these are the only people besides senpai in this world that you cannot kill. For some reason, you just enjoy them too much. And yes, this is actually the RPG aspect of talking to them, building relationships with them, having fun, and this is just for the more introverted gameplay people who don't want to murder right away, but just want to relax and have a good RPG session. In school, you can also add points to your character. So, if you go to class, there's a class. So, if you go to biology, you can put points into biology. Now, the points will actually be a lot slower because I think this game should last a little bit more than it should do now. It won't be a week arrival, but you can take your time. There's an actual limit of how long you can wait, but it's a lot longer than just a week, because it's not, you know, You can also do side missions, which, you know, what's her name? The bitch with the glasses that's mysterious? She will give you side missions, and once you do those side missions, they can be anything from stealing something to giving homework to her to getting students expelled, or panty shots, just like normal, you will get money. And money is good. Also, school is used to locate the target, as the only place you can kill any of your rivals is at school. They will stay in school mostly, or at least they won't be outside, because there is actually a town in this game. So you can locate the target and devise a plan to kill them. After school, this is where you do more training so you can put more points into stuff, but you can join any club. This is where the clubs come into play. Basically, each club has a ragtag team of new and more interesting characters that you can have mini games with. Like chess, you actually play chess, and you can get specific upgrades and power-ups if you beat all of the chess people. Like, if you get to the top of the chess club, you get certain abilities to go into certain classrooms. You could get like a skeleton key or something, so you can go into different classrooms at any point in time. That could be sick. And like in the cooking classroom, you can now put poison in cupcakes if you get to the top of the class without anyone noticing. There'll also be some mystery stuff, like, you know how the club people are like really weird and ghost. There'll be a whole mystery or storyline following that and finding maybe a cult of some sort, and of course you make more friends. Then the hangout period of the school. This is where you get out of the school and you can do several things. You can connect with the characters more and meet up with them after school, go to the park, play more mini games, or just wander around and discover new objectives and items. But also you can purchase things. I'm gonna come back to this because this is a very important aspect of the game, but purchasing things is a lot more important than you might think. Also outside of school, there's special events and items like Easter, Halloween, all kinds of stuff. And then we have pajama time, which is sleep. Sleep time, ha ha ha. Okay, but what about killing? Well, there won't be so many changes to murdering people because, you know, murdering. But now there is a social aspect to it, and this is a super fun bit because I really enjoyed this concept, is that there's a social aspect to it. If you buy a knife on day 2 and then kill them on day 3, the police now know that someone bought a knife the day before someone got stabbed with one. Now, since this is a smaller town, they're obviously going to investigate into that, and now police will be suspicious, which is one of their 3 levels. They'll either be suspicious, which means they're investigating the school, or know that it's you, but they don't really have any evidence. Or then there's investigation, which means that they're actively investigating you. They'll be found throughout the school, sneaking on you, stuff like that. And locked on, which means they have full evidence on you, and unless you can somehow disprove it or distract them completely or even kill them, you will be caught and arrested. But like I said, besides the police, there's a social aspect to them. Every rival is connected to your base friend group. If you kill someone, then the main cast knows that they're dead, and they know that you're a bit psycho, so they will actually attack you and try and make you confess. Now, this is where I brought some Danganronpa into this, where you have to gather evidence during killing someone to disprove them. You have to give them alibis or not, because if you don't, they will tell the police and they will arrest you. So you can't be sloppy killing someone before or after. So leaving any evidence that they could use against you is extremely forbidden. You cannot do it. You have to be extremely careful when you kill someone, which makes it more like, okay, lead you away, stab, 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 okay, put you in the trash, that's it, gone. No, there's real evidence and there's DNA. You have to be extremely careful when you kill. Oh, also, there's an extra little layer to this, is that, you know, like I said, if you buy a knife on day 2, the police will know that you've bought a knife. If you kill someone with a knife, well, guess what? You can actually get your friends to buy other weapons or things for you so that suspicion is spread out. But if you ask them to do this, they will get more suspicious, and the next time they encounter you about it, they will get, the actual challenge will get harder because they have that evidence on you. Together we can show the world what we can do. Menus and students. I think the menu system in Yandere Simulator is really bad. I think it just doesn't fit the fucking theme at all. And the prompts of like press A, press X is so out of place. I hate it. It burns my eyes. My eyes burn when they see it. Holy, oh, my eyes. So we're going to have something else. If you are talking to a student that you've never seen before, then congratulations. You haven't seen them. You don't give a shit. You're a psychopath. You're a yandere. You don't give a shit about them. So the actual menu will be cracked, maybe into three pieces or maybe into four. This will limit your options with them, which means you have to get more attached to them to be able to do more stuff. And it'll be random. So if you go up to a student and you want them to follow you away so you can kidnap them or something, then there might be a chance that following isn't on that list, isn't on that three section. So you have to get closer to that student or just choose another student. And the more you come in contact with someone, the better options they have. So you can use this for your secondary friends in club rooms to get them to do something for you. Now, I was wondering how you can differentiate important characters from the classic just students randomly there, right? And I had an idea, which was pretty poggers. There could either be some kind of glow around important characters, or they could be way more flamboyant. I think having a glow is a bit more realistic, because Yandere Simulator, like, you know, the Yandere-chan, or whatever the fuck it, Yandere creator, the guy who makes Yandere, Mr. Yandere, he wants all the students to look really cool and really different, so, you know, having them all, like, be classic greys, and then having one of them be super bright head colored isn't really the style. So having some kind of glow, or maybe students that you don't give a shit about don't have eyes, or don't have pupils, or their features besides their hair are just kind of numb because she doesn't care about them. She's a yandere, she's a psychopath. She does not give a shit about people who she doesn't want to use, which could be another aspect to the menus changing over time. Missions and rivals. Now, here are some missions that I just wanted, you know, to do so you can get money to buy stuff like chloroform and knives. So you can do pandy shots, stealing phones, light hitman, like doing pranks and stuff, destroying evidence, getting students expelled, and ruining classes. And basically, that's it. There could be loads more, but that's just all I thought of. Rivals! Okay, so I'm not, you know, I can't actually criticize the rivals in the original game. Because, you know, they haven't been released after 6 years. Not a single one of them. So, let's make our own rivals. Yeah. Now, I'm not going to make 10 original rivals. So, we're just going to make the first one and then the 10th one. To just show you how difficult they can be. So, rival 1 is Mosana. Yes, Osana level 2. Mosana is the school smartass and has fallen for Senpai. Her schedule is pretty basic. Completely basic. She spends 50% of her time in the library, and the other 50% of the time either near Senpai or at the local sushi shop. Sushi, hoo-hoo! Killing her will be pretty damn easy. Learn science to be able to study with her and gain her trust, or just outright kill her. But I'm not doing 10 original rivals, so let's just skip to the 10th rival. Holy shit. Fenial. Why is he hard, and why is he gay? I don't know, because he's gay. He's a karate master, so you can't fucking kill him, right? He also works in the cooking department, so you have to beat him, and also, he can tell when there's poison in your food. He's very social, he changes his schedule constantly. He's inside your main friend group, he's literally one of your friends, and he wants to talk to Senpai, like, all the time. Like, all the time. Ah. Okay, you've now finished the base game, you got with Senpai, congratulations! Woohoo, yay, woohoo, yay, yay, woohoo, woohoo! But what do you do after that? What do you do after the fact? Well, I made some new modes for you. Here you go. Survive her. In this mode, you play as Senpai, and Yandere is hunting you down to kiss you, and you must hide for a week. It's basically just constant sneak missions, which seems pretty interesting. Snap. You have to kill one person a day. It's basically a super hard mode. You have to do the exact same thing. You have to kill 10 rivals, but you have to kill at least one person a day, which just really difficult. And hidden, you must kill all rivals in one day, so they're all there at the same time. And so you must play the original game first to know their patterns, and then learn their patterns compared to each other. And you need extremely hard but interesting plans, you know, to get one to be there when you kill the other one, so you can, you know, pretty badass. Okay, so here's the conclusion. If Yandere Simulator came out like 2 years ago, 3 years ago, I think no one would be mad. He would have released a good indie game and everyone would be like, okay, that's Pog. It would have sold well, but it's been 6 years and it's not even 10% done. It's not even 10% done and it's been 6 years. Sorry for the change of tone, but this game is never coming out. It's never going to be finished. And that's it. Although I love the concept which led me to this video, his execution sucks. And this video is getting really, really long. So I do hope you enjoyed. If you did watch this far, you have to subscribe. If you don't, you'd just be an asshole. But that doesn't matter. I really do feel bad for people who are waiting for Yandere Simulator because it isn't coming out. And if it does, it won't be worth it. No game can lead up to this amount of hype. No game. Even made by Masahiro Sakurai or Kojima. Nothing. Nothing could be made to lead up to the hype. You know, most video games have like 2 to 3 years at most for the hype. You know, they're being made for years and years, but, you know, they only announce it 2 years before release. And I just think he either released it too early to the public, or he just shouldn't have told anyone, or he's just greedy and he just keeps not working on stuff to make money out of Patreon. So, yeah. Hope you guys enjoyed. Please like and fucking subscribe to the video. If you don't, I'll kill you. I'll stab you in the face, and that's all I can do. That's alright. That's it.
Do it, you little shit. I said fucking do it. I'll beat the shit.